Guys, I have a pal here, but it's me, Jaden. I am filming a Bible study today.
Hold this thing together, close your eyes and take my hand. Cause what we have is something special, baby. Let's just take our chance.
This is about the seventh fruit of the spirit, faithfulness. And this is Augie.
Hey, hello.
Your name is so cute. Can you smell my sandwich?
You're adorable.
Are you cuddly?
So handsome and sweet.
Thing together, close your eyes.
Let's get started. Faithfulness. What comes to your mind when you hear the word faithfulness? Maybe staying faithful to God after facing temptation each and every day. Staying faithful to God even after sinning countless times against Him. Staying faithful to a friend who is personally fighting something, or maybe the other way around. Or do you just think about faith, believing in something that you cannot see? This is a quote by Oswald Chambers. I found it in my devotion book. Faith is a deliberate confidence in the character of God, whose ways you may not understand at the time. Hebrews 11:1-3. Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. For by it the people of old received the commendation. By faith we understand that the universe was created by the word of God, so that what is seen was not made out of things that are visible. 2 Corinthians 6-7. So we are always of good courage. We know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Hope you all caught the walk by faith, not by sight. In our faith journey, our faith can sometimes be challenged. I feel like we need to question our faith. This is normal. I've been through it, but I came out of that scary time stronger in my faith. Have you ever doubted or questioned the existence of God whom we cannot see? It takes a whole lot of faith to believe in what we cannot see. Very much includes our God. I was in fifth grade. I was up late. I barely slept. I kept having doubtful thoughts about God, and I was so confused as to why I was having them. I was bawling. I had my mom come in my room. She was in my room for almost, she was there for a few hours. It's normal. It's like, it's horrible. It's hard to believe in some things if you can't see them. Easy to doubt them or to question them and their existence, and that includes God. I remember going to school the next day, and I was barely there. Like, I was crying all day because I felt so guilty. I'm out of that, so strong in my faith, and I have been growing my faith and my connection and relationship with God. I've been noticing more things that prove to me He is real. God's miracles, answered prayers, and the beautiful things we see every day assure us that God is real. God is with us always. And God hears us, loves us, and is always there for us. There's some things you see every day or every few days that reminds you of our God. I see flowers, I see the sunrise, the sunset, I hear the birds, and I see the birds, I hear them chirping, and the beautiful trees, the blooming flowers, and I get to breathe and have another day. And that tells me God is taking care of me, He is sustaining me, and He is in me. For all things from our God only. Psalm 8:3-4. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is man that you are mindful of him? The son of man that you care for him? We worship a mighty and real God. We only need to have faith. The most important fruit of the Spirit, I believe. Because we need to believe in God even though we can't see him. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!